Hello friend, my name is Sunil Kumar. In this video, we will learn how to start a mule flow using expression. So start mule flow using expression. So we will make the flow initial state as stop so that I can start it. So let's first create the HTTP connector to receive it. We use the VM as a outbound endpoints, and we will use the expression component started. So let's configure this quickly. So I will make this HTTP as a default component over here. We will use the path as expression. And the allowed method I will put as post. So let's configure now the VM. Let's make it as the queue name as Sunil. Let's make its default configuration. I can say the queue store, I will use file queue store. It automatically persists the all the message in this file so that when the server next time start, it will pick it. And in the expression I can use app dot registry dot and in my another flow name, which now let me create this another flow name. So I will use as a VM in this flow as a inbound endpoint. So let's configure this VM. So as a inbound, it will use the same queue name, it will use the VM, and I will use the set payload so that I can see what payload is there. In new flow I will say, and I can also use one logger to see if this get printed or not. So I can print my payload over here, and this is the another flow name which I am trying to start using expression. And let's make this initial state at stop. So it means once the application will get deployed, this flow will not started by the mule, and we will use this expression to start this flow. So we will use this dot start. Let's save it, and I have my JSON already printed, but first of all let me start this flow. Okay, so this will get the request, put into the VM as a outbound. It will start the flow. This flow will get started, and the inbound VM will process this request, and the respective logger will get printed. And now, so server is started. Let's run it and see its behavior, how it is behaving. So initially the first flow will get started. We can see into the logs that second flow, it will not start. So in the logs, it shows that the second flow, it is in the stop state. So over here, I can see the second flow is in the stopping state. Okay, so let me hit it. So first time, if I hit it, run, and I can see the new flow message. If I hit it one more time, it throw the exception, and the exception it's throwing is that already in lifecycle phase start. So it means that the flow is already started by the mule, so I cannot restart it again. So for this condition, I can make it is as conditional, saying that I will start my flow if my flow is stopped. So I will use app dot registry dot flow name dot is stopped. So I will start it only once if it is stopped. So for the first time it will start this flow, and for the second and the for rest of the time it will not start, and then it will not throw an exception. So let the mule application get deployed, right? So it's deployed automatically. Now try to run it. If I run it, oh, so again the error. So let's see what mistake we have done. So there is some issue in the expression that we have done. So see, Let's see what we have done wrong with it. Okay, so this parenthesis is missing over here. Let's make this parenthesis. Oh, so now there is no error. Let the application deploy it again. So it may automatically deploy the application. So application deployed successfully. If I hit it for the first time, I can see the in new flow, and what this new flow is for the last application because it persists the payload. And next time it run, it will show successfully. If I hit it again multiple times, I can see now there is a no error and in flow is get printed again and again. So in this way I can make it as conditional, and I can play all other expression like app.register flows dot start stop, different type of the phase. I can check it. Thanks for the watching. Thank you.